Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, Dio here with another First 10 Turns guide on the very hard difficulty in Mortal Empires. This time we're looking at one of the new DLC lords, Torox the Brass Bull. As usual, move your spellcaster hero into Torox's army and attack the settlement of Storag Kor. Beefy start is very easy, so much so that you can auto-resolve through the first portion of the game without any issues. I will fight this battle manually, but the rest will be auto-resolved to show you how you can easily progress even with large army losses caused by the auto-resolve. After the battle, choose to raise the Hearthstone to create a blood ground. Remember, if you raise the settlement and then raise the Hearthstone, it'll count as colonization and you'll have to replenish most of your army before you can proceed again. Grab Gargantuan Hooves on Beefy and Devolve on your Shaman. Start off by building Winds of Malady to have a small chance to spread disease in enemy settlements within the Bloodground and to reduce enemy vigor in battle. Begin researching Raining Blood in your tech tree. Also, build Heads on Spikes in Beefy's Horde for passive dread generation. It's worth recruiting the Ungor melee units from your local recruitment and raiders from your Horde recruitment to fill up the army as quickly as possible. Move Torox north, but make sure you have at least 10% movement left to switch to Hidden Camp. Recruit another 3 units of Ungor raiders. You should be able to get non-aggression packs with most Beastmen factions and get a ton of money from them, so check your diplomacy often. Attack the settlement of Shortak Mount. As I mentioned before, I will auto-resolve this, but you can fight manually to get better results. Make sure you choose the raise in advance post-battle, as you'll need the extra movement. Move as close to the Red Desert as you can, but make sure you have enough movement left to in-camp. Grab Dark Apothecary on Torox and Vile Tide on your Shaman. Use this opportunity to disband any regular Ungor spearmen and replace them with Ungor raiders. You will be able to perform a Ritual of Ruin, but do not do this just yet, as we need at least 25 marks of ruination for the next tier of upgrades and a second army. Attack the settlement of Red Desert. Once again, I'll auto-resolve this, but fighting this manual will yield better results. As tempting as it may be, make sure to raise in advance post-battle for the extra movement and replenishment. Begin moving Torox down south and encamp again. Grab Dark Apothecary on Torox and Traitorkin on your Shaman. Replenish your army post-battle as required. I merged some units to replenish and recruited more to make a full stack. On turn 5, this event will trigger. I personally go for the Gorbul, but either will do as heroes are easy to get as the Beastmen. Switch Torox to Raiding Stance for the extra movement he gets from it and run down south towards the Plain of Spiders. Your hero will spawn by your Hearthstone, so begin moving in towards Torox as well. Declare war on the Tomb Kings and attack the Plain of Spiders settlement. The auto-resolve predicts a valiant defeat. However, if you encircle the settlement, disband one unit of your Ungor raiders and replace them with your new Gorbul hero, you'll be able to auto-resolve this battle with some losses. You can either loot and raise, or raise and advance. Move Torox southeast and encamp again. Recruit new units to replace any you may have lost in the battle. Grab Dark Apothecary on Torox and Bestial Surge on your Shaman. Upgrade your main horde building to tier 2. The Dark Moon event will pop up on turn 7. As my army is beat up, I'll go with the full army replenishment. If your army is in fighting shape, you should choose one of the other great buffs. The Temple of Adaeth will be controlled by either the Wood Elf Sisters or Dark Elves. With the Sisters holded, it's likely they colonize the Plain of Spiders during your end of turn. Either way, attack the settlement regardless of who owns it. Either of the raise options are fine here. You can backtrack and take out the Sisters in the Plains of Spiders or begin moving north. Grab any of the blue skills on Torox and training on your Gorbul. Upgrade your Pits building to tier 2. Begin researching Consume Order in your tech tree. We are finally ready to perform a ritual to increase our army capacity and recruit new units. Recruit a new lore of your preference, it really doesn't matter which you choose, and recruit some Ungor raiders on them. Use your Dread to upgrade your Hearthstones to tier 2 and upgrade your existing Hearthstone settlement. Move Beefy Boy up north, set up camp, and recruit new units into his army. I went for all 4 Gore units and a Chariot unit, replacing his Ungor infantry and Harpies. Recruit Harpies and Ungor units in your second army instead. Grab Vile Tide on your Shaman and Blademaster on your Gorbul. Build Heads on Spikes in your second horde. You can also upgrade your Winds of Malady building. Switch Torox to Raiding Stance and attack Kragroth Deep, and move your second army on the border of Storag Kor and recruit more Ungor raiders. Begin researching Worldbane in your tech. Move your second army into the Dark Elf territory and recruit the last units for a full stack. This army will raid and attack easy settlements for money and experience. Continue pushing with Torox to wipe out the greenskins. And that's it, the first 10 turns as Torox the Brass Bull on the very hard difficulty in Mortal Empires. If you had to backtrack and fight the Sisters, you should have activated your Rampage, so you can actually use it to push the greenskins on turn 10. It's worth upgrading your Hearthstones to tier 3 ASAP, so that you can have 2 buildings in each settlement. Don't forget to spend some money on really strong items like the Champion's Essence and Blind Eye of Seeing. It's also worth spending Dread on increasing your hero capacity early and recruit them as soon as you have the buildings. Look out for heroes with Nurgle's Foul Sting for a very strong leadership debuff. The benefit of the Beastmen is that you can go wherever you like, but Naggarond and Hexotl are part of your victory conditions, so it's worth staying on this side of the map. If you like this guide, please don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more guides and Let's Plays on the channel. See you next time. Toodles.